Abby and Alex.
Hi, Dan.
Dan Reichert.
Let's get blasphemous.
I always.
All right, this is a game, a video game called Blasphemous.
You have a very pointy head.
That's why I said that, yeah. I got a pyramid head thing going on here. Some comparisons that we can make right off the bat.
Let's do it.
With this. All right, the look.
It looks like, what's it called? That game everyone liked last year.
Dead Cells.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, it does.
Very much looks like Dead Cells. Has some comparisons. It's got the Metroidvania thing going on here. Also, unlike Dead Cells, which is extremely kind of fast-paced, roguelite, really action-y game, this is much more deliberate, I have found. I'm about a quarter of the way into the game, according to the percentage. And one of the Dark Souls elements it has here is when you die, you see these red things?
Mm-hmm.
That's where my corpse is.
Your desiccated cisterns.
Yes, and I should go back there, but it's kind of a unique thing that it does. It doesn't do the... You don't lose currency, basically.
Okay.
You can see I've got currency in the top right there that helps me buy upgrades and things like that. When I die, it limits the amount of fervor, which is the blue bar up there, which manages like spells and well, they're called prayers.
Okay.
And it also lowers the rate in which I accrue currency until I find my body.
Okay.
And absorb it back into
my person. So there's a penalty. It's just a different kind of penalty than, say, your average one of these games.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
And you can see here, there's a whole lot of stuff going on in this game.
This game looks cool. I like the look.
It's got. I want to get some places that look cooler in this area, because there are some that are just like really, really striking. But lots of just weird lore stuff that... it's like the Dark Souls thing, where it's just like, you don't really know what these descriptions mean. It's all very serious in tone. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, these items here have their own lore and everything to them. You know, all sorts of upgrades and stuff here. I'm finding these peanuts or bones or whatever the hell they are.
I'm going to say those are probably closer to bones than peanuts.
Okay, yeah, that could be the case.
I would love it if this guy was collecting peanuts.
He just loves peanuts.
The most blasphemous of nuts.
Yes. He's going to a baseball game.
Yeah, as a kid, he went to baseball games with his dad. He has fond memories of peanuts. It's hard. This game's hard. I wouldn't say it's, like, especially punishing, especially since the death penalty is really not that bad.
Well, look
this.
At his jaunty ladder climb.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Just having a good time. Let's see if I can find my body. Let's go to the right and up and try to get that one, because I think it is poisonous to the left.
Okay.
The platforming is not the best part of this game, I don't think. And that's one of the things that I think the comparison to Dead Cells is kind of rough in terms of, like, yeah, visually it looks like it, and Dead Cells performs a certain way in just kind of its speed. And again, this being more deliberate, it almost just kind of feels slow at times, but I don't know. That might just be unfair to say because this is a different game. It's doing different things.
I mean, they might be going for a different vibe altogether.
They definitely are, yeah. They do some really cool cutscenes that I would love to see one of them, but to be honest, I'm kind of lost right now. So what I'm supposed to be doing is killing these three bosses to open this giant bronze door.
Okay.
I've killed one of the bosses, and I'm kind of just walking around trying not to die. There's my soul.
Oh, there you
Get
are.
Get it.
That's, what was it
Get
that killed
Where's
me?
The blasphemy?
There's a whole lot of religious stuff going on in this game. I don't know what any of it means. It's a lot of like, penance and guilt and sins and death.
Okay.
But
Dan,
I think
is this game metal?
Probably, right? Oh, shit, I did.
Oh, you got extremely blown up by that thing.
Shit, okay, so Estus Flask, basically.
Okay.
I smashed that thing on my face.
Is it refill?
Yep, when I pray, it's like prayer altar thing.
Oh.
So there's also that. You can hit RB to deflect.
Okay.
The window is pretty generous, so I've not found it to be too hard. Oh, is that guy good? Okay.
Those guys just keep respawning, huh?
Yeah, I don't want to die.
Yeah, I don't want you to die either.
I would like to keep going and see a cool non-goopy sewer area. Oh, what's that guy
up
to?
What's that guy's deal?
Hey, dude,
Town
what's up?
Crier?
Well,
is he good? No.
No, he's dead now. He could be good. I don't know.
Well, you murdered him, so now we'll never know.
What do we got here? I got an empty bile vessel.
Is that good?
Let's see.
Fill it.
Vessel made of crystalline gold capable of holding the hallowed heil that... So it's like
bile.
Stuff like that. Like, I don't know what the hell this does. It says it's a quest item.
Morning fountains.
Like, there is so much text, and it's all blood and...
All right, we need to go find some bile, is what I'm thinking.
All right. I want to get out of this fucking area. Here.
Yeah, this is there's a lot of slimy shit going on in this area.
I've gotten a couple upgrades. I got this like down thrust thing, pretty nice. The boss fights have been really like detailed and cool. Like a lot of really interesting animation in this game.
Mm-hmm. The way you're moving and your character moves and just kind of everything moves is a real nice. Like you said, it's deliberate, but like the animation's real good.
Yeah, totally. Even in the cutscenes and stuff, it's like. It's going for disturbing at times, definitely. It's lots of, like, babies crying blood and ripping their entrails out.
Oh, you're saying it's blasphemous.
It is blasphemous, yes.
Imagine being able to pull yourself up by just one arm like that.
I've never been able to do one pull-up. I don't think I could do that.
Yeah.
Am I going to be able to get out of here?
Where are you right now?
And you're playing on the Xbox One X.
I am.
The performance has been good, yeah?
Yeah, and I think I saw some reviews from the Switch version that did not have any complaints, so this is always good. This could be a cool Switch game. Okay.
I don't like it when that guy blows up.
No.
It hurts you real bad.
I wish he would stop doing that.
Does he just come back to life? Looks like he just respawned
like
there.
It, yeah.
So remind me what the blue juice is again.
Blue juice. Ah, yes. Thank you. That is my fervor. So that is...
like a religious fervor.
Yes. Oh, by the way, this is like a rosary that you put beads on a rosary for different things.
Okay.
Let me see. Okay, so here's the prayers I have. I will turn this one on. This is more of a offense-based one. The other one I have, it basically just makes it so... Oh, that's cool. All of my attacks are speedier. How am I going to do this? Do I have to... Okay. There we go. And then if I go straight up... I don't really like the map. I don't like how you have to like
hover
over it.
Can't tell where you are.
Yeah. Okay, let's go. All right. And...
Ooh.
Yeah, the timing.
It seems like you have the timing of that pretty good.
Yeah, yeah. And like the boss fights and everything are, you know, real traditional, like learning patterns and counterattacking and stuff, and it all feels pretty good. But now I'm out of my Estus Flask things, and I want to get to a prayer deal.
A prayer deal?
A prayer deal. You know, I went to Catholic school.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's what they're called. It's frustrating, though, because you will die fairly frequently in this game, and the prayer deals are not plentiful, I would not say. So it's a lot of backtracking. Like, I've been through this area a lot, and it gets kind of old. Like, once you've seen all the enemies and stuff like that, it's
right.
just like, okay, I'm just doing this again. Especially if you've died a few times, you're not even getting that much currency back. It can feel like a chore at times, for sure. I'm not going to go down there to get my soul. I want to go up and see some new areas. Nope. Guess I'm not going up
that
there.
Way.
Never mind. I'd love to find a boss fight or something here. Oh, hey.
That idiot didn't even see you coming.
I don't think he's ever really fought back. I might just be killing an innocent man over and over.
I think that guy might...
rang a bell. Is he like a shopkeeper?
Well, so no. I think he might be causing some of those enemies to respawn, because it seemed like some of those like blow-up guys were stopped spawning after you killed the one before.
Oh, okay. Whoa. Maybe that's
so, like, maybe he's just like a summoner.
Okay, that could be it. What is this? Ooh, I don't...
Is that a new area?
Okay, there's a...
The Mountains of the Endless Dusk sounds pretty fucking metal to me.
Yeah, let's look at some of the names of areas here. We got the Desecrated Cistern.
Uh-huh.
Albero, the Holy Line.
Uh-huh.
Brotherhood of the Silent Sorrow.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, this is my shit.
Yeah, Mercy Dreams.
Uh-huh.
You get the tone.
Bridge of the Three Cavalries.
Yeah.
Okay.
You get what the tone is that they're going for here. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this area is pretty cool. Hey, sorry if there was a weird cut. The TriCaster died. Back to this.
It happens.
There was a weird cut. It's not an if.
Shit.
Oh, boy. Off to a great start.
Oh, exemplaris excommunicationis.
I think that means you did bad.
That means game over, yeah.
Does that happen a lot?
God damn it. Yeah, I've died plenty. And this is what I'm talking about with it getting frustrating, where it's like, all right, now I'm all the way back here, and my body's over here.
There's no fast travel?
There is, but I only have 2 points of fast travel right now, and so it's hard to... I mean, it's like there's one door here,
uh-huh.
and then there's one door like way back somewhere. Like,
how do you
there.
Unlock the doors?
Unlock them?
Yeah. How do you?
The fast travel?
Them? Yeah.
They just have to be there or not be there. You know, it's there's
cool.
not a lot of them.
Well, you know what? We're in a new area anyway, so let's just check this out.
Yeah. Hey, NBA. There you go.
Cool.
Yeah.
Hey, video games.
Quick looks in the queue.
Yeah. Tonally, same type of game.
Yep.
Uh-huh.
Yep. There's a boss fight here that was pretty cool. Lots of weird things where it's like, oh, here's this lady I've never seen before, and she says, like, oh, your sins come to pass, shall I desecrate your assistance? And you have to say, like, yay or nay, and then it's like, I don't know what I just said.
Well, obviously you say yay.
I did say yay, and then she showed up in a boss fight and said prayers and gave me health, so I'm glad I said yay.
Okay.
Yay.
I've not been down here.
I have a question.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you like this game?
It's good. It's definitely well made. I really appreciate the art. I don't know if it's doing enough new on the gameplay front, because it is very much, you know, what it looks like. It is a action platformer with Dark Souls elements and, you know, reversal windows. It's not doing anything particularly crazy in that space, you know?
Yeah.
And it's also not so good on a mechanical level that I can say it's fine just on that
front. It seems like it plays well, but it is very much leaning on its aesthetic and its, shall we say, blasphemous vibe to sort of carry it, which, I mean, you know, to me is like, I could see myself getting into this, but
Can you go the other way?
I don't know that playing it is necessarily the thing that I am looking most forward to.
Yeah, and I would even, here's a warped door.
Yeah, all the aesthetic is rad, and I wish this was like an adventure game, I think.
Oh, yeah. Let's go back here. I would recommend too, I wish I would have been able to get some cutscenes or boss fights here or whatever, but if you're watching this and you like what you're seeing, I would say check out some YouTube videos of like boss fights or the cutscenes and stuff, because there really is some cool stuff there. I can't afford anything. This is the thing where you can pray to upgrade and get new attacks and things like that.
Pray to the upgrade gods.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Why are you trying to kill the peasants?
I don't... everything seems bad in this game, and so I always just
they
do a
don't
little
seem
slice.
Bad. They're just trying to live,
yeah, they're
man.
Fine. They're fine.
They're not doing anything.
Oh, what's in this weird...
Good question.
That... You just... Where did you just go?
Oh, this is my peanut gallery thing.
Oh, okay.
This is this is where I keep my peanuts. What does that term actually mean, peanut gallery? I've heard that.
I think it refers to... So I might be speaking out of my ass a little bit here, but I think it refers to folks who were in like the standing section of like certain shows and events of like, this is the peanut gallery. They're the ones watching and like the cheap seats.
Okay, gotcha. Okay. All right. Well, that's...
But I could be wrong. I'm going to Google it, but I think it's something to do
I
with
I think
that.
You might be right.
Okay. Well, that's my jail where I keep all my peanuts, basically.
Okay.
I want to show one more area off here before we get out of here. You'll see all these areas a lot. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know how big the game is. I'm a few hours in. It says I'm 25% based on the completion thing. It seems like there's a lot of collectibles. There's little, like, cherubic things. Cherubic?
Yeah.
Cherubic things floating around that you can
babies.
Collect. Yeah,
little
it's
baby
weird.
Angels.
Yeah, it's like vultures carrying babies in cages. There you go.
Whoa.
Speak of the devil.
This
that's
game
weird.
Looks so cool.
Yeah.
I wish that it was a style of game that I enjoyed.
Yeah, I really do like this type of game, and I just don't... That's not really grabbing me as much. I'm not big on the, like, confusing for confusing sake, kind of Dark Souls lore type stuff, so that's not doing much, but the aesthetic, absolutely.
Wow, check this out.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on here, man.
Oh, yeah. Look at that shit.
Wow.
That's bad.
Fucks up with those guys.
I don't know. I don't Stakes. Like anything going on here.
Wow.
I like that whatever that weird zombie body is, they just picked up a statue and decided that was a weapon.
Yeah. Well, like here.
That's what
see,
they're, like, attached
sometimes
to it.
It's like good to kill these things, I think.
I think you're putting them out
because
of their
they're
misery.
Suffering. Yes.
Yeah, I think that's what they're going for here. Oh, I'm in the wasteland of the buried churches.
Oh, cool. Yeah. I remember that album. Fucking rips.
I would normally be fighting all these things.
Yeah,
but
you're
just
trying to show off some stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Man. Some of the bigger enemies, like the animation, is just fucking crazy on them.
Even the animation all the animation looks really nice.
Really
yeah.
good.
I would say, you know, I don't dislike Dead Cells aesthetic, but even though there are the comparisons to that game here, I think this definitely looks better.
Yeah, I think there's just like more variety of stuff going on.
Totally, yeah.
Yeah, he's not wearing big dumb shorts like in Dead Cells.
I never noticed shorts. I guess, yeah, it always just looks like a big...
He's got, like, Kingdom Hearts pants.
All right, yeah. Let's go up here. I don't think I've been to the left up here, unless this is a new area to the right. It's pretty much the same. I've been there. Okay, I'm going to try to go up and see if I can go left at all, and we'll call it there. All
right, sounds good.
Yeah.
It's $25. It's on every platform.
Everything. I've not tried the Switch one, so I can't say firsthand, but I have heard nothing bad about the Switch version, so...
Yeah.
Because even like Dead Cells had some performance issues on Switch back when that came out. Did they ever fix that?
I don't know. I
mean,
don't
I
have
played
that
it on the Switch and I didn't notice anything.
Okay.
But I'm not like the biggest frame rate nerd.
Right, what the fuck? Okay.
Whoa, right. Take.
Am I just going to take this?
Yeah.
All right. I'll take that, man. Or are you what
you
is
cool?
that?
It's like heart a statue.
Do you need all right. Do you need help?
Equip a sword heart and mea culpa to modify its properties. Oh, okay.
What does that mean?
I got a sword heart. Let's see.
Can you put it on your sword?
Here it is. It looks like it... Oh, maybe I don't have a... Oh, boy. it's a lot. All right, well...
Yeah, Mountain of Ash, got it.
That was probably important.
Yeah.
All right.
So that's Blasphemous.
That's Blasphemous. It does some cool things. If you like what you see, maybe YouTube it, or just buy it if you want to play it and get into a moody, weird, churchy game. Thanks for joining me, Alex and Abby.
Thank you, Dan. Thanks, TriCaster.